All right. Point number 7, Goliath. Crisis comes with rewards. Now, the man Goliath was a big challenge for the people of Israel. But do you know that Goliath came with a reward? They said, do you see this man? Anyone that overcomes this man will marry the king's daughter without paying money. Free. So Goliath was a Christ that came with a free wife. Not only that, they said, that person's family will no more pay tax in Israel. Goliath, challenge, enemy, crisis, but with what? Reward. Point 8, crisis offer opportunity to reveal leadership. Crisis offer opportunity to reveal leadership. We're not talking about who? David! The Bible said he went out when Saul was pursuing him, and all those who were hungry, all those who were in debt, all those who were distressed, they came to David. People in difficult situation. What happened? He transformed them into what is known as David's party. David's mighty men of valor. Why? The crisis moment was a time that molded their destiny. Point 9. Crisis spells solution. Do you know about United Nations? Have you heard about United Nations? UN. How did it come to be? Crisis. Is as a result of World War II. When they saw the magnitude of the destruction of World War, they said, no, we cannot allow this type of thing to happen again. They formed what is called League of Nations. They now said, let us come together and unite so that this type of destruction, it was crisis that united the world. When we hear UN, United Nations, is after the World War 1945. That's when UN was formed. And that's why today, in this nation, begin to suppress this nation because they are more powerful. Other nation will come to and see the smaller nation and ask you why? Why? Because the world is now united as a result of the catastrophe of World War II. Praise the Lord. Point number 10. Crisis bears growth. Crisis bears growth. Do you know that today is the Feast of Ascension? It is on a day like this that Acts of the Apostles chapter 1 verse 8 was written or was recorded. It was when Jesus came to give them the last instruction that he said to them, remain in Jerusalem because you will receive power. I'm sending the promise of the Father. Acts 1:8. You will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you so that you will be my witnesses. It was on a day like this. And while he was telling them that, while he was still talking to them, he began to go, ascended, Acts chapter 1. The Bible said they were still looking up when some angel came and said, as you see him go, he will return. But he said, you'll be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in Judea, in Samaria, and all the ends of the earth. Do you know what happened? When the power came on Pentecost, they all remained in Jerusalem. Until Acts chapter 8 verse 1, when Christ hit the church, because of the crisis of persecution as a result of the death of Stephen, that was what made them to go to the next phase. If not, they had remained in one place. So it was crisis that made them to fulfill the mandate. So crisis brings growth. Acts of the Apostles chapter 8 verse 1 is the fulfillment of Acts of the Apostles chapter 1 verse 8. Chapter 1 verse 8 says, we will go out. Chapter 8 verse 1 says, they went out because of persecution that came as a result of the death of Stephen. Point 10, 11, crisis brings invention. It gives birth to invention. I had a story that the person that invented the law of gravity was a school dropout because they say he has a blocked head. Doesn't know anything. At the backyard of their house, mango fell on that blockhead. He tapped. He beat the mango and said, my friend, go back to where you came from. He threw it up, it fell again. I said, why is it that you can no longer go where it was? That was the joint that said the law of gravity that states that whatever goes up, it's back. We know Bill Gates. When George Bush was the president of America, Bill Gates are the richest man on earth. They say he can pay the president of America his salary for 132,000 years. But you know that Bill Gates was a school dropout. He said he does not have brain. In that crisis, he developed something. Microsoft. crisis. Push your neighbor to say crisis. Crisis is good. Point number 12. Christ's great testimonies. Christ's great testimonies. Are you having health crisis? That is why somebody is a doctor. Without crisis of health, one doctor will die of hunger. Every crisis is another person's testimony. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You have a court case. That's why someone is praying as a lawyer. If the lawyer is praying for God to prosper him, what is he praying for? Crisis. If the doctor is praying for customer, what is he praying for? Crisis. So every crisis is a testimony. If you are praying for your car not to break down again, you want mechanics to die of hunger. And if mechanics are praying for daily bread, what people are praying, let's say, let your car break down. Praise the Lord. So you have to see crisis in the proper light. So there is not every crisis that is meant just to make people cry. There is the good side of crisis. Praise the Lord. Alright. Point number 13, we are still looking at 18 facts of crisis. Crisis develop character. You don't know whether somebody is a strong person until he comes into challenges. That is why James chapter 1, from verse 1, he says, count it all joy when you fall into all manner of challenges. See, because that is the testing of your faith to bring patience, to bring character, and so on and so forth. Is it not from tests that you get testimony?
Sure.
Do you want testimony?
Yes, sure.
Do you want tests?
Yes.
People want tests, but they don't want tests. Tests is another name for crisis. Tests is another name for challenges. So how can you come and say, thank God I am now healed if you were not sick? So there has to be a crisis that will give birth to
testimony.
Testimony. Praise God. So that crisis develop character. So when you are going through the crisis, it's not for you to begin to cry, God, why have you abandoned me? God, where are you? God never does not move. So where he has been, that's where he is. And not here he will be. Hello? I was about to tell you, I would say, as it was in the beginning, it is now. And never shall be. That is God for you. Point number 14, crisis reveal level of strength. The Bible says in the chapter 6, verse 10, after having all done all, stand your ground. That means don't let your fire be quenched. Many people are no longer standing their ground. There are people who were faithful yesterday, they are no longer faithful today. The Bible says, having done all to stand. Someone say, I will stand. Jump up, say, I will stand my ground. Jump up and say, I will stand my ground. Say, my fire will not go off. In the name of Jesus. Listen to me. Proverbs chapter 24, verse 10 says, anybody that fails in the time of adversity, it means his strength is small. So crisis come to reveal the level of your strength. Anybody that fails in the time of adversity, it means that his strength is small. Proverbs chapter 24, verse 10. Ask for neighbor, is your strength small? Point 15. Crisis reveal the level of faith. Crisis reveal the level of faith. It was when the storm came that Jesus knew that the apostles were people of little faith. Say, oh yeah! Of little faith. What the Greek calls oligopistos. Oligopistos, little faith. Do you believe? Do you believe? Because all things are going well. It is when challenges come, will we know whether truly we believe. It's not by singing it. You try, let someone come and advise you go to that native doctor. You forget that you used to tell us that you believe. It is crisis that will reveal your level of faith. Ask whenever, have you been tested? Christianity is not by mouth. The Bible says gold has to be purified by fire. When you are being tested, the Bible says count it all joy. Testing is not easy, it's not sweet. It is with understanding you are able to scale through. Praise the Lord. All right, verse 16, it in fact about crisis. 16 says, crisis gives opportunity to prove your faith, whether it is active faith or whether it is passive faith. All are being proved during crisis. Philippians 4:19, we only 4:19, everybody lies. Philippians chapter 4, verse 19. My God shall supply all my needs. The God wants to know whether what you have said with your mouth, whether it is truly from your heart, then your last one shall be born. Everything born. You say, hey, I am feeding. But you say, I'm not to supply all your needs. And you see somebody going to fall into the fire that is burning his house or her shop. Here the person says, God supplies all my needs. At that moment of crisis, he or she forgets God. Praise the Lord. Somebody loses job. He goes and commits suicide, kills himself because he was sacked. Yet he said, God is his provider. Listen, Christianity has to be tested. Your faith has to be proved. All these things come to know whether your fire can stand the test of time or not. I am finished because you are shocked. God for it. We know the story of the building collapsed. Woman whose children died went to and took her own life. Praise God. Where is your faith? So someone may be in church and they think that because the person is well dressed, the person understands Christianity. If somebody kills himself, where is the person going to spend eternity? Don't you know that hellfire is real? How can somebody suffer on earth and still suffer forever? What right do you have to take your life? Many people, guess who are here and you are contemplating taking your life? Please, it is anti-Christian. It is wrong. Yes, and we still say it with our mouth. No condition is. Then okay, why should somebody take his life if it is true? If it is not lip service. The Bible says, Jesus said in Matthew 12, ex abundance here and need, for this us love with all. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. But today, what we do is lip service. Lip service. Amen. Point 17. Crisis places more demands on the head than on the hand. Crisis places more demands on the head than on the hand. Meaning, while laborers and workers are fired, consultants are hired. Laborers and workers are fired. Consultants are hired. Others are laid off. Others are employed. Why? Consultants have something to show from their head. Workers work with their hands. In the moment of crisis, the man is placed on the head more than on the hand. Meaning, if you are defeated here, you will be defeated here. Consultants are people who use their brain to bring solution. Tell your neighbor, use your brain. Use your head. Why am I telling you to use your head? Because I know there's a crisis in your life already that is trying to make your fire to go off. But use your head. Use your brain. God will give you wisdom. Why workers are fired, consultants are hired. Praise the Lord. The 18th factor. God ordained the crisis. Counsel see at the end. Praise God. Oga, come. If this Oga is undergoing some crisis moment, if God is behind it and his faith is in his God, at the end he will have a testimony. How? Somebody say, how? His faith in God. And the God he has faith in will cancel or cross the sea in the crisis. And when sea is canceled from crisis, what happens to him? He rises. With a good sea from crisis, it becomes rises. Meaning, if you stand your ground, you will surely rise out of that challenge. Am I talking to somebody? Tell me, neighbor, stand your ground, stand your ground. If you stand your ground, you will surely come out with a testimony. Come out with a victory. Come out victorious. Because the Bible says, Romans chapter 8, verse 31, see Deus pro nobis, qui contra nos. If God be for us, who can be against us? But so we are much more than a conqueror. Who is a conqueror? A conqueror is someone that is involved or has been involved in a contest. You cannot conquer me if we never tested ourselves. How can you say you have conquered me? It's only if we have fought. Either with me, we are in a contest of race, or football, or boxing, or fighting, then you win. That's when you say you are a conqueror. So you cannot be a conqueror without winning anything. Hello? How come ordinary mosquito is conquering your face? Ordinary mosquito. You are crying because of mosquito. Where is your faith? Ask your neighbor, where is your faith? Ask Joseph. Ask David. Joseph saw himself in the pit. He persevered. Potiphar's wife, he persevered. Prison, he persevered. At the end, did he rise or not? He saw himself in the palace. At the time of pit, is it pleasant? Is it pleasant to be in the pit? Is it a good thing to be in the pit? To be a slave, is it a good thing? To be a prisoner, is it a good thing? To be a prime minister, is it a good thing? You see that the end became good, even though the beginning was not good. That's what the Bible says. All things work together for good to those who love God, who are called according to His. Stand on your feet, stand on your feet, stand on your feet, stand on your feet. Stand on your feet. Say, I will end better. Say, I will end better. No matter the difficulty, no matter the situation, I will end better. Make it to prayer. Make it to prayer. No matter what I'm going through now. Maka shekerebo. Imagine the prima salvalagaba. I will end better. Leka posa kalagana bush. In the name of Jesus. Lift up your hands and pass a decree over your life. No matter the crisis in your life, in your family, in your destiny, in your academics, you will come out better. You will come out victorious. In the name of Jesus. Somebody jump up and shout the fire. Sit down. Let your fire keep burning.